Let's go live to Greg Sheridan, foreign editor at The Australian. Greg, the largest election in the world, the counting begins soon, and Modi set for another term in India.
Yeah, it looks like it, Kieran. So I tell you what, this is a good period for old men, isn't it? Modi, deep into his 70s, is going to be re-elected prime minister, an extraordinary rule in India. The exit polls are all pointing to the BJP, his party, getting a majority in its own right. The National Democratic Alliance, which is his coalition of parties, getting an even bigger majority, and maybe even getting a supermajority, which allows him to make all kinds of structural changes. He's been a pretty good leader for India in terms of its economy, but there is a concern that he has, had touches of authoritarianism. India is still a democracy, but, he's a bit rough on the press that disagrees with him, and he campaigns a little bit against the 200 million Muslim minority, and he has really wielded a supermajority amongst Hindu voters, which is the overwhelming majority in India.
Yeah, well, I remember last year I asked a question of Narendra Modi when he was walking alongside the Prime Minister, and he looked at me with a very shocked look. You're not used to having journalists lob questions at him, Greg.
No, he's a completely different style of leader. He's not married. He doesn't have any kids. He's not going to found a dynasty. He's very religious. He's been very competent. Very competent, and this is a profound historical change. I mean, India is going to grow at 8% this year. It is the fastest growing big economy in the world. It hasn't become an absolute ally of the West, but it is a tremendous balancing force to China. You know, it has a deep nuclear arsenal with all of China's cities covered, so that means China has to think very seriously about India.
Yeah,
it's now the biggest nation in the world. You know, it has more people even than China. It has fantastic connections with Australia. More than a million people of Indian origin now in Australia. Tremendous soft power all over the world. Everyone loves India, the Bollywood movies and all the rest of it. So it's a different democratic culture. I mean, you would have been there when he toured the cricket ground with Anthony Albanese. I don't think Albo's ever in his life had so many people cheering him. You know, he thought, Australian crowds tend to give you the Bronx cheer, not the unironic cheer.
Exactly right. There's no Anthony Albanese stadium like Narendra Modi Stadium in Gujarat, that's for sure. Let's turn to Nigel Farage. We spoke about a good time for old men. I don't know if Farage qualifies, probably, but he's having a run now after suggesting he wouldn't.
Yes, I mean, this is devastating for the British Conservatives, absolutely devastating. I wrote last Saturday, the Conservatives now concede that they're going to lose the election very badly unless there's a miraculous intervention. But what they were trying to do was save the furniture and make sure they remained the dominant centre-right party. So they want at least 100 seats, 200 seats would be a pretty good result. Now, they are threatened by Farage's Reform Party. So I think Farage and Boris Johnson, the two most influential Conservatives in the last 20 years, they created Brexit. And Farage, with his former UKIP party, United Kingdom Independence Party, they used to win Britain's European elections. So he was the biggest British party in the European Parliament. Now, in British elections, they've had the bad experience of getting millions of votes but no seats. But if they get millions of votes this time, they will absolutely cruel the Conservative Party. And if they make a breakthrough with a handful of seats or even a dozen seats, then they're in a position to challenge the Conservative Party as the dominant centre-right party. Or you could even see a merger. But Farage has so much more energy than any of the Conservatives, that it might be more of a takeover than a merger. That's all a long way away. But Farage, for him to enter the election and say he's going to run, that's a very bad day for Rishi Sunak and the Conservatives.
Yeah, indeed. Makes it ever more likely that Keir Starmer is the next Prime Minister, will be anyway. Greg, thanks. We'll talk to you next week. Appreciate it, as always.